Welcome to my podcast, HORIMONO STUDIES. I'm Carlos. Today we're going to speak about topic. It's Mikiri. No, I'm joking. It has quite sophisticated Japanese terminology and names, but we're going to try to make it as simple as possible. That's what we're doing during these videos. So, let's start with the first image. In this image, you would see a simplification of all the Mikiris.
Wow.
Mikiri is basically how a Japanese style tattoo finishes, like the borders between the area that has no tattoo and the area that has a tattoo. So it could have different shapes. These are the famous Mikiri. And there are different types of Mikiri. We're going to see them in this image. We have all of them. Some of them are quite rare and some others are quite popular. So let's go with number one. Number one is the weirdest of all of them. You would see in the image I show you at the beginning, it's called Matsuba Mikiri. And it's inspired by the pine needles. Pine trees are often used in ukiyo-e and irezumi, and is normally referred to be connected with the season of winter. So Matsuba Mikiri is an edge that ends in some small lines, and it's really weird. You normally don't see it anywhere. There are almost no references about it. So actually, the only one I found is one from a video from Orihiro Mitomo. You could check his page, and in this video, I'm going to have an image here. He speaks about this image he found about this really weird Mikiri. So number two is Botan Mikiri. Botan Mikiri, Botan means peony, and it's one of the most common flowers in Japanese culture. This Botan Mikiri finishes in a shape as the petals of the peony. Is the most common one nowadays, and almost everybody with a Japanese tattoo has this Botan Mikiri. Then we have this Bukiri. And Bukiri, I like the description I saw in a page. It says that it's like if you have a katana and you just cut an edge, and you would see a straight edge. So as in this one that Thomas Pinedo did on my sleeve that we're still working on. It's a straight edge. You would see this. It could be here in the munewari or in other parts of the body. Normally, you would not see it here nowadays. Nowadays, people prefer this Botan Mikiri. But yes, it's this straight finish of the tattoo. Then we have this Akebono Mikiri and the Yari Mikiri. And personally, I found them quite similar. The difference I saw with Akebono Mikiri is that it's finished like with a shading, and Yari Mikiri not only has sometimes the shading but also has some dots like in the classical ukiyo-e. So these are the main Mikiris, the main five. Now let's check some images so that to see if we can understand them in the best way. They're not organized in a specific way, so that we can actually come back to the names properly. So actually I had to study this topic again. Let's go with the images. So in the first image, is actually I found some very good schematics. There are some people trying to simplify these ideas so that customers could see the information or could approach this information in the best way. So my first image is a schematic by Kensho II, and it shows the Matsuba Mikiri, this one really weird Mikiri that you are normally not able to find in real life. So second image from Mephalem Tattooer, Sorry if I mispronounce your name, man. I believe this is a really good example from the Yari Mikiri. And as you could see, it looks a little bit similar to the one you see in the tattoos of the heroes in the ukiyo-e, with these dots at the end. Here I have another example. It's from Oye Tattoos, and you could see the dots over there. Quite badass over here on the head. I believe it's quite a good example. It looks quite clear. Somehow it's been recently somehow a little bit of a hype with this Yari Mikiri, and some people that try to be a little bit original between the traditional Japanese zin are trying to use these different Mikiris. I find it okay. It's quite interesting, quite cool. Maybe there are not much old references, and that makes it a little bit too open to interpretation, but I believe it's still quite a nice finish. Here there is another view of this tattoo from Oye Tattoos with this Mikiri, and I believe it's quite appealing. You'd still see some contrast, you see some background. It's quite nice, I believe. Here I see another example, also from the Yari Mikiri from Marius Meyer. You would see over here, this is done with smaller dots, scattered a little bit. It gets this sandy feeling in the end. I believe it's not for everybody, but it's nice, it's beautiful. Then we have, I believe this is what I would understand a little bit like Akebono Mikiri. This is an image from Fetty's tattoo. He has this a little bit neo interpretation of the Japanese, even with some of the rules of the Japanese. He has amazing tattoos, really good technique. But if you see this finish, is not especially with small dots, like with the Yari Mikiri, but it has some fade over there. In this other image, we have another schematic by Kensho II. In this schematic, you see the Yari Mikiri and the with dots. In this other image is what I wanted to show you, is one of these heroes of the ukiyo-e done by Kuniyoshi. And normally we have these tattoos with the Yari Mikiri. Here there is another schematic by Kensho II with this Yari Bokashi. Here you see the scattered dots. And actually I found today this other schematic by Fabio Gargiulo. Cheers to you, man. Beautiful schematic, explaining a little bit the Mikiris. You see the bottom Mikiri over here, the Matsuba Mikiri, Yakebono. Really well studied, beautiful schematics. I believe this is something nice so that our customers could understand this topic in the best way and they could actually decide a Mikiri. Here we have an schematic by Kensho II again, from the Akebono, this shading in the end. This other schematic I've seen some days ago is from Horishun from Kurichiba. Cheers to you, man. Beautiful schematic, also with the Matsuma Mikiri, the Yakebono Mikiri, Botan Mikiri. Really well done, beautiful. Sorry, guys. Now I see maybe the only image that was showing in the internet, this Akebono Mikiri, and it has some shading. I tried to access this website and I was not able to do it, but I believe this tattoo artist also has more of this Akebono Mikiri endings. So if you know his name or her name, please let me know in the comments. The same with other of these guys, if you know them or if you know their pages, please mention them or write me the name of them. This schematic I found that it was beautiful. It says that it's from Andy Canino. Cheers to you, man. It has everything. It's beautiful. Butsugiri, Bota Mikiri, the Akebono Mikiri, Yaki Mikiri. It has the main shapes. We're gonna speak about some of them in another tattoo, in another video. Sorry, guys. So beautiful schematic. And here we see another simple example of what it's normally done nowadays. This button Mikiri, this is from Hori Yamato, from the Horitoshi family. You see this end, like the petals of a peony. I believe this is from Master, it says Horitaka. I would say this is a bit of a mix. It has a little bit of a Botan Mikiri, and in between the shading, it feels a little bit like Akebono Mikiri, but I'm not sure. But okay, amazing tattoo, powerful with the snake, and a classic from Horiyoshi III with this beautiful Botan Mikiri in the Munewari, and also some Bukiri here at the end that is actually quite popular in the end of the sleeve. So I wanted to show you also this one. This is from a movie poster. It has a Bukiri, this like a katana edge, and you could see it over there in the three quarters length that he has, and also on the edge here in this area. Here you see another classic with Botan Mikiri. So I hope it's been clear with the images. If you have any questions, suggestions, please let me know. Remember to check at the end of the week, I'm posting a review about a Japanese tattoo artist in Instagram. You can check it over there. And over here, next week, at the beginning of the week, I might post also a new episode of this Horimono Studies. See you next time.